and we just placed all the buildings, so we know more or less where everything is going to be. Of course, afterwards, if you don't like it, you can always adjust it a bit. We are going to create some elements to make the city really look like a city. I mean, right now there are lots of empty spaces, and we are going to fill them up with buildings or maybe a couple of boats here in the ocean. It really depends on what you would like to add to your city. In this case, we are going to give it a bit more of a character. And for that, I am going to start with the first element. The first element is going to be the bridge that I'm going to draw over here. Make sure that you draw it in the right layer. I make use out of simple shapes such as the rectangle tool and the ellipse tool. To create a similar style of bridge, you can draw three rectangles, and you make sure that the outer rectangles are darker in colors. Then you make two circles, and by using the Pathfinder tool, you create a water passage underneath. That's the first element. We've got a bridge right now. Okay, and now we are going to make the wave breakers. So it's just going to be something very, very simple. We are going to start off with a simple square. Copy that. Place it here on top. Drag the anchor points down an angle, place another square next to it, and drag the anchor points up again to close the shape. Give each side a different color. Just like this, and group it by using Command NG. What we are going to do right now is we are going to place it underneath this layer. The easiest thing is to create a new layer. Go here to the right, base layer. It's set on the base map, but we are going to create a new layer and we place that layer underneath. Okay, so we've just created a new layer. We go to the base map and we click on Object, Unlock All. And the background is going to be unlocked. So that's the blue ocean. We're going to copy that. Well, no, we're going to cut it and place it in layer number 5 right now. I'm going to call this one Ocean plus Blocks. And this one, I'm going to lock it again by using Command N2. The block I'm going to cut as well and place underneath. As you can see, if I place it slightly underneath this ridge, underneath this edge, then yeah, it fades away. So I don't really want that. I'm going to change this color, even make it a bit darker. Yes, much better. At least you can see the difference when it's placed underneath. And now we are going to place these ones all over. Just copy it, place it, turn it around a bit, and do the same. Oh, but be careful that you don't take the base map again. I'm just going to set that as well, so or to lock it so it doesn't go away. And just keep copying it. Again, turn it. Move the blocks randomly and make sure that you don't have a cluster of blocks that have the same angle. Okay, so right now you can see that it's more or less filled. But what we are going to do is take the pen tool, draw a shape that is going to go underneath the blocks to make the appearance that it's all filled up and it doesn't look that empty. You don't have the blue gaps in between. So I try to make it as naturally as possible to join the different blocks together. So from here to here, that's through this part. and close the shape. We are going to give it a darker fill color and send it to the back. And like this, it looks a lot more natural again. Well, add more blocks where necessary, obviously. So now we've got the wave breakers on these this side, and it already looks a lot better. Okay, now for the extra elements, we are going to add some clouds. Clouds are very simple. It's the same as the bushes. So we are going to create some, but we are going to make a new layer, and we are going to place that layer above all the other layers. And it's going to be here. Clouds. And as I told you, it's very simple. Use the lips tool. I'm going to change the color to white. Okay, that's one cloud. And we are going to Pathfinder and unite the shapes. What we are going to do next is we are going to copy the same cloud. We go to blue and we go one shade darker. We are going to place this underneath the cloud but in an angle so that you can see the cloud underneath and might seem as if it's a shade. So try to take the same angle as you got over here, which you did with the map itself. Doesn't have to be perfect, but it looks a bit more natural. And like that, we are going to create a couple more. Okay, the next object is going to be, let me see, we are going to create a couple of buildings because as you can see it's quite empty over here, so it's best if we have a couple of buildings that can fill it, and we can do that best here. Okay, so I'm going to show you how I'm going to make a small house to add in the empty spaces, and it's going to be a simple house. And it's a typical apartment building, which you can find here. And I'm not going to add too many details again. I just want to keep it simple by using mostly the rectangle tool. And I'm going to change this to a different color. Let's say, I actually want to have it white, but you don't see it on the back, this background. So I'm going to add a different color background. And add some windows to it. After placing the windows, you can place a door, and I've used the rounded rectangle tool again. And you can add some details to the building, shift everything around until you set everything into place. Okay, so now I've created one of the typical houses, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the background and I'm going to group this. Okay, as you can see, I've made this house, and it's to fill in the different gaps here in between, and I'm going to make a couple more to have a bit of variation. And you have to think about what you want to do for your city, I mean, which kinds of buildings work the best for your type of city or village. So take a look at that and try to make a list of things that you really want to include and what works best for you.